Hi, everybody. This is Val Hart, and I know today is a really interesting day because here in the United States, we change our clocks. It's the fall, and tonight we fall back an hour on the clock, but not really in our body, mind, and our animals usually freak out about this, right? They're like, what the hell? You're not feeding me at the same time. We're not walking at the same time. It's like they feel unstable. And I know you probably do too in some ways as well, right? I know I do. I hate time changes. Can I get a like on that? I hate time changes, except in the fall. I like getting an extra hour. It's the spring that I don't like losing an hour. Okay, cool. So some areas of the world don't do this, but for those of us that do, and whether you change tonight or at another time, I want to give you some tips on how to take care of that, how to help your pets understand and the time changes. So I got a note from my friend Scott this morning, and he said, I was walking my dog this morning and I realized that tomorrow we're not going to walk at the same time. How do I explain that to him? How do I help him with that, right? And I've also seen a lot of stuff this week on Facebook about, the dogs going, this is bullshit. You're not feeding me on time. What are you thinking? I think it's hysterical. So here's what to do. Talk to them. Tell them what's going on, right? Tell them. Talk to them. Here, I made some notes. Let me find my notes. Where is my note? Ah, here we go. There you go. All right. So here's what you need to do to help your pet. The short answer is talk to them always, right? So tell them what's going on. Tell them why, as best you know, why we're changing the time. And then start by sending them a message so they know what you know or what you're thinking that they don't know yet. So I teach you how to do that, how to send messages to animals in my free ebook, Hidden Secrets to Communicating with Pets. You will love it. If you don't have yours, go get a copy at learnhowtotalktoanimals.com. But I'm also going to give you some tips on how to do this and how to talk to them about the time change. So the first thing you want to know is that animals really do understand time. They do. They get morning, they know about, night, they know what the routine is, they're really in tune with you, they know when you're coming home, they know what to expect, they figure it out, they know what days and weeks and months and years are. So the first thing to know is you being clear about time. I know for me, I'm a little old school, as you might can tell from my hair, a little older. So when I was growing up, we had analog clocks, right? The clock face where the hands go around and around. Nowadays, we have digital clocks, digital things. So for me, it works for me to imagine the clock and see it go to a specific time, like 3 o'clock, right? 5 o'clock. 10 o'clock, 6 a.m., that kind of thing. So when you get clear in yourself about the time, then they will be clear too. If they're not clear, they'll ask you a question. They'll say, wait a minute, I'm not real clear about that. What time again? Just tell them. They'll know. You can feel the difference between times a day. You know how 5 a.m. feels different than 8 a.m. Then that feels different from 2 a.m., right? How morning feels different than night. You can just feel the time in your own body for you clairsentient types, claircognizant types, or for the clairvoyant types, see it in your mind's eye, see the clock, see the time of day, see it, or you could hear it, if you're clairaudient, hear it. So as long as you get it and you're clear, your animals will usually be clear too. And if, like I said, if they don't, they'll ask you for clarification, right? The other really important thing is to manage your feelings about the time change. Are you happy about the time change? Are you upset about it? Frustrated? Irritated? Whatever you feel is okay. You just want to be conscious about it so you can address it, right? So they can understand it. Oh, I see a reaction. Hi, everybody. Hi. Show me some love. I know you love your pets. I'm glad you're here. All right. So what how you feel about it is really important. And the reason for that is because animals pick up your feelings. They pick up your energy really easily. And then they look inside your head. They want to see what you're focusing on. What's on your mental monitor? What are you imaging, right? And then they listen to what you say. They put all that together to try to make sense of what you're communicating. So if you're telling them a happy story that you actually don't feel very happy about, then it's not a happy story, is it? Be honest, be clear, be in alignment with what you're thinking and saying and feeling. Because when you communicate with animals, the three things are: see it in your mind, feel it in your body like you're experiencing it, and then tell them the story. So see it, feel it, and say it. All right. So this time, and this topic is about the time change. So tell them the story about the time change. Tell them why it's happening. Just talk to them like your best friend, which hopefully they are. You can also explain that this is out of your control. You can't help it. You didn't do this, but we are affected by it. And so this is what's going to happen. This is how it's going to affect them. And tell them how you're going to adjust, what it means for you. So this means that I'll be going to work an hour later on Monday, and I'll come home an hour later, right, on the body clock. But on the physical clock, again, analog or digital, hopefully will work for you, that will feel like an hour later. But anyway, so tell them a story however you best can, and then ask them for their help. You know, say, you know, I need your help with something. I need your help to ease the transition, ease this adjustment, you know. And so tell them, be specific. What do you want them to do, right? What do you want them not to do? What won't be helpful? Be clear about when you're be feeding them. Right? There's an hour difference. When will you be walking them? And so on for the weeks to come. And so that's the first conversation, right? When you tell them the story, often you're going to get some thoughts come into your head, or you'll hear something back and it will be, well, okay, that makes sense. Or, okay, I'm confused about something. Or they'll have a question. Right? They'll say something like, well, does that mean whatever? If that happens for you, answer it, address it the best way you know how, from your heart, right? Then the week continues. You're going to remind them every day about the time change. And so when you leave for work that morning, or whenever you do, tell them, or school or whatever you're doing, tell them, okay, I'll be leaving at this time, and it will be different than the last many months, but it's okay, and I feel okay about that. And it also means I'll be returning a bit later, right? And that means that their walk time will adjust. I'll walk you when I get home, or whenever you do. Your feeding schedule will adjust, and so on. So tell them the specifics. Be clear. Then comes the physical part. The actual doing of it. So I want to remind you to be very gentle and easy with yourself and them as you adjust to the time. It's really fine to feed them at a little different time than normal, or earlier or later. You can totally give them a snack to tide them through until you've all adjusted properly. So be gentle with yourself. Anybody else got any questions? Be sure and post a comment below. Let me know. Let me see. I want to give you the link. I'm going to give you the link so you can go get your ebook. And that will tell you. I think. can't type and talk at the same time. Go to learnhowtotalktoanimals.com. Get your free ebook, Hidden Secrets to Communicating with Pets, and learn more about how to talk to your pets. This is so important. We have to pay attention to what our pets are telling us. We need to be clear. You know, they're your best friend. You want to help them. They want to help you. You know, connect at the heart, connect at the mind, feel your love for them, right? All right. Thank you for loving animals. Don't see any comments. So if you have something later, you're watching the show later, comment below and I will come back and answer your questions. All right, everybody. Thank you so much. Love you all. Thanks for loving animals. Talk to you soon.